got another job here, which is quite difficult. We're in Burgess here, quite local. And this pond is deep. Like, I mean, when I say deep, I really mean it. And it's not much silt in it. It's mostly leaves, rotting leaves, very stinky. And the leaves in it, I'll show you, is about 4 or 5 foot deep. So the machine is literally floating in the silt. I'm struggling to get any more water out of it at the moment. So, because that silt is acting like a sponge. So what I'm trying to do, the boys carry on taking the stuff out, making a sort of a hole or a cleanish area here. I'll show you where we're loading right now, and I'm gonna pull in the edges, and that will push the water into the hole overnight, and we can pump it out. The plan. Other than that, I got no other plan. Really, that stuff really should be pumped with a silt pump. What we don't have, so it's not our job, by the way. We've been just hired in, so. I do what the busman says he wants. So just pull in the edges like that. Give a little foot pressure to the stuff in the pond. And hopefully push that water from the middle around into the low bit. might be a bit of a trouble here.
Thank you. this is just super crazy. Unbelievable how deep this pond is, and it's just leaves. Leaves. So there's a high ground there. That's why Bamford is there at the moment. And that's really deep there. That's where I had trouble to turn. So we have to reduce the levels overall for me to be able to go back in there and grab the rest. So we carry on scooping, pumping, scooping, and pumping and scooping. I think it's water, but it's actually a couple of leaves. It's thick enough for the pump to not.
Extremely deep. We're about 10-12 foot down now. And we're running out of room in the field. So I don't think there's much more gonna come out. I mean, it's plenty deep enough. So it wouldn't affect the pond itself. And that's where we're tipping. The owner only owns that side of the field. That does not belong to him, so we can't touch it, which is a shame. But this is what it is. It's all on a hill. I don't know if you can see it or not. But that runny stuff. We did build a barn down there. I don't know if you can see it. Down there. And it's full up now. You have to be careful because you end up tipping in a top here and just keep tip, and all of a sudden the whole lot is starting to slide down and you can't stop it. And it's a river running down there, so we can't let that happen. There's plenty of tidy up to do after we finish.
Somewhere, find the bottom. Still quite a bit in here, but at least we see where we're going now. There's the bottom right there. We got another two issues now. Issue number one, I can't feed the long reach quick enough. Second, which is the biggest trouble, we got dumper drivers, pretty much different ones every night. And you know, with all my respect, none of them really machine related or very top of faith, you know what I mean. In the beginning they've been tipping all over the place. We got really a restricted area to tip to, and we're running out of room really fast. Really a push to get it all in there. Well, you know, we'll see what happens. Carry on until we actually have to do something about it.
And that's the day one before last. And this is how we're looking. So there is a tiny bit left in the corner here. I want to drag that here. So that bend there is there for a reason. So this area here is much higher where the digger's sitting than that middle bit. Is about 2 feet lower down there. So I had to build that little bend, so keep the stuff up here for the long reach to load. 6-7 meter long.
Pressure. There you go, baby.